today we're going for the first run in the New Balance 1080 version 11. Now this is just my first run and I will be giving you my first impressions of this shoe. My full review will come after I've run at least 100 miles. If you like running, if you like getting new running shoes, why not give this video a thumbs up right now? And it just gives me a little feedback that you like the content that I'm putting out. Let's go for that first run. Great first run in the New Balance 1080 version 11. But today's run was a steamy run. It was 75 degrees, which is 23.89 Celsius. It was a soaker out there. Today's first run was 12.1 miles, which is about 19.47 kilometers. An average pace of 7.42 a mile, which is 4.47 a kilometer. There was 1 mile that I picked it up. I think I dropped it down to maybe a 6.25 average, which I think for me now, based on my current fitness, is probably around a 5K pace, maybe a bit quicker, maybe a 3K pace. But these shoes held up pretty well at my normal speed and then when I picked it up. Let's get inside and we're gonna go over the shoe. Oh, it was toasty out there, guys. And okay, so because it's so toasty, the first thing I wanna do is talk about weight. And that's gonna make sense in just a second. Now, New Balance reports in a men's size 9, so UK size 8, that this shoe weighs in at 9.3 ounces, which is 263 grams. In my size, men's size 13, US size 12 UK, it tips the scale at 11.4 ounces or 324 grams. Now, as you saw, it was a toasty run. I sweat a lot. And this shoe put on some weight during that run. In fact, it put on 25%. After my run, this shoe now weighs 14.3 ounces or 404 grams. Now, I don't want you to think too badly about this shoe for gaining that much weight in such a short amount of time. It was very humid out there. It's very hard to get around gaining that much weight when you are just sweating profusely for the whole run. It's actually a fairly lightweight shoe. The 1080 V11 does run true to size. However, it runs true to size from like front to back and it felt good for my whole run. However, if you notice right here, it is cinched a little tight. And I did find that I had to pull it that tight in order to get a good lockdown across my midfoot. Didn't really have any effect on the performance. I didn't notice it once it was tied down, but just now that I've picked it up to look at it, it does look a bit funny with it cinched down. Maybe if I went to a 12.5, I might have a little more space in between my laces. Who knows, maybe it'll be too short in the toe. Let's start at the top and work our way down. New Balance has made some changes from the 1080 V10, and the main change is in the upper. They're using an engineered knit upper, a hyper knit, and in this V11, they've engineered it to be a little more pliable, and that's designed to give your foot a little more room to move. Now, while it wasn't immediately noticeable while I was running, when I did think about it, I noticed that my toes kind of felt really good in the front of the shoe. And that's something I do notice when it doesn't feel good. I generally get a little bit of pressure here on my little toe. I didn't have that in these. We have the New Balance N on the side, just kind of giving a little rigidity and helping it lock down on that midfoot. The tongue is a very thin, but not absurdly thin. It's still a padded tongue and it's gusseted. It is attached to the inside. And again, that just helps with the lockdown across the midfoot. Moving to the back of the shoe, we can see this very pronounced flare right here. And that just takes the pressure off your Achilles tendon. The heel counter is quite rigid. In fact, it almost feels like there is a piece of hard plastic right at the bottom that's keeping it very rigid. The heel collar is about as thin as you can get. It is very thin and almost elasticated. And when I looked at it before I went for a run, I wondered if that was gonna be enough cushioning. And it turns out it was. This rigid heel counter really gave the heel of my foot support and there was no heel slippage. I didn't notice anything to do with this minimally padded heel collar. And it's a good thing. If you're not gonna notice it, why do you need all this padding? It just adds to the weight. All right, let's get down to that midsole. Okay, this is a neutral running shoe. It does have a fairly big stack height. It's got 30 millimeters in the heel, 22 millimeters in the forefoot, making this an 8 millimeter drop. I do like the 8 millimeter drop. I found that I like between 6 and 8 the best. Now, the midsole hasn't changed from the 1080 V10. New Balance is still using their Fresh Foam X midsole, and for good reason. The midsole just works. It is a fantastic foam. It is very light, it's responsive, snappy. I don't know if snappy's a word I would use. It was pretty responsive once I picked up the pace. And it is squishy. Can you see this? I can squish that very easily. And while it didn't feel that squishy while I was running, when I was walking in it, it felt insanely squishy. Like when I put them on before I went for my run and I walked around the house, it felt like, well, I can't think of any other word to describe it other than super squishy. That changed once I started running though. It wasn't too much, it wasn't too little. It was like the Goldilocks amount of squish. Moving on to the outsole, we do have a 7-piece blown rubber. Well, 6 pieces of blown rubber. This white part in the middle is actually just the midsole material. And then we have the blown rubber in the places where the shoe is actually gonna hit the ground. And you can see these little ridges coming around here, separating the bits of the outsole. That just allows it to flex beautifully. And that flex contributes to the toe off. So this shoe fits squarely into the daily trainer category. And by saying daily trainer, I mean it's kind of a jack of all trades. It does pretty much everything well. I ran fairly slow today on my first run. For most of my run, I did pick up the pace to an above tempo pace, and it still felt pretty responsive. I probably wouldn't grab this shoe if I was going to do a track workout or I was really gonna pick up the pace. Probably wouldn't be my race day shoe if I had something lighter with a bit of a snappier toe off, but if this was your only shoe, it would definitely work. I can see why the 1080 has been such a popular shoe for New Balance over the last couple years. And of course, if you ever get to version 11 of a shoe, you're probably doing something right. So how did this feel to run in? It actually felt pretty good. I was very pleased with how this felt. It actually felt light on my foot. And while it's not light by any stretch of the imagination, there are a lot heavier shoes out there. And I've actually been running in some of those heavier shoes. So this was a breath of fresh air. Squeezing the midsole like this, it's very deceptive. Because when you pick up the pace, you actually are getting some energy return that seems a little counterintuitive once you see how squishy this midsole is. Okay, this has just been a gush fest for the New Balance 1080 version 11. I will give you my full opinion after I've run at least 100 miles, but after my first run, it's pretty good. Retails at $150 in the US. I think it's £140 in the UK. And who do I think this shoe is for? If you are just starting running and you need one pair of shoes to do it all, this is your shoe. Have you run in the New Balance 1080 V11 or the 1080 V10? Let me know in the comments below. Let me know how you have found this shoe after you've logged a couple miles, especially the V10. And I really wanna hear some negatives because after my first run, I've got nothing but good things to say. All right guys, thanks for staying all the way to the end of the video. New videos twice a week. Be kind, be happy, run well. See you in a couple days.